After the main shaft in the first episode and the secondary shaft last episode, it's time to get heated as we have to throw the whole engine into an oven to apply the bearings.
Okay, next thing on our list is to check all the bearings and bushings and put them into the crankcase. Start with the bushings for the swing arm of the engine. If you have cracks in the rubber or even the screw is not in the center of the bushing, I suggest to replace it. We have already removed the old silent blocks and this is the new one we're going to put in there. And for the bearings to assemble, we are going to heat up the engine case in an oven. Since the moment when the engine is hot is kind of short, after we take it out of the oven, we have to prepare ourselves very good. And so for every size of bearing, we need the proper punching tool. In this case, there's a very good SIP punching tool, exactly matching to the outside ring of the bearing, and when we punch we will not hurt the inside ring nor the bearing balls. It will work very fine. And for the other bearings you can use different, we have different punching tools in our stock, but you could also use the nuts you are using on your big wrench. Make sure that the main bearing, the clutch side bearing of the crankshaft, you put inside from the back side of the crankcase. Because if you put it in from the front side, there is a big chance that you're going to lose the slot for your circlip. Some cases, the more modern cases, which is not the case here, they don't have the backside spring clip. So you need to apply the bearing from the front. But you still have to be very careful, because if you punch too much, then you're gonna punch the bearing through the whole engine case and it's broke. But then it's also a repair kit is available, but it's only a second best solution. I'm not very happy with putting the engine case on this surface. So I have some help. I'm using one of these two tools to put inside here, and then I have a plain surface where I can punch on, which is directly behind the slot of the circlip. So the force is directly going from the circlip or from the bearing seat to this wood and does not have to cross all the wall. Let's apply the circlip. In this case, we can put it inside from the back side, which is the better way. There's almost no danger that you punch it through. Ganz langsam und sanft. Okay, I think the engine case is now medium rare done, so I'm gonna take it out of the oven. Okay, now we are going to check if there is a gap between the circlip and the bearing. But there is no gap, so the bearing is completely in its seat, which is perfect. So the next bearing is in its seat. And we can check from inside if there's a gap, but there is no gap. No gap is the best gap. Now all the four bearings are in its place. 1, 2, 3, 4. And they are all completely down to the surface on the other side. We can check. And the next step is to put in the silent blocks in the big half. Even the bushings are in its place. The only thing missing is the silent block for the rear shock absorber. But we can also insert this in the workshop because it also works when the engine case is cold. Now let's secure the freshly pressed in bearings with these circlips. Wow! Perfect! Let's finish the insertion of the bearings and the bushings by assembling the last bushing on the rear of the engine. For this I have the rubber piece and I'm going to use the flywheel puller to press it in. A good aid for this process is some soap from the kitchen. And to aid, you can use the bench vise. I don't use oil such as WD-40 because the oil will remain in the bushing and keep it slipping, whilst the soap will disappear because of the humidity of rain and so forth. Now the bushing is in its place, the steel tube is symmetrically aligned and everything's fine, we can proceed.
Alrighty, next time we're going to assemble the engine for the first time. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. Plus activate the bell so you won't miss out on any future projects.